St. Lucia over the last 4 days has recorded 3 homicides, at least 2 of them occurred within hours of each other. Acting Police Commissioner Errol Alexander says that police are devising strategies to return calm to the city's streets. The police say that they hope that the law-abiding citizens stand behind the police when they take action.
I cannot see whether between two gangs, whether it is a war that is going on. No. Our intelligence have to indicate what the situation is between the two. And as we speak, I'm not even too sure whether the war is between the two usual gangs that we have been thinking of. But we know that the persons and them were involved in the shooting are very young people. And very young people that the elders in the community at least should help us identify these people, because at the end of the day, it don't only affect St. Lucia, it affects the community where they come from. So when we the police combs the community, I hope the elders and them don't complain.
Speculation is rife that police will not respond to shootings as a result of the recent impacts investigation of extrajudicial killings by officers. Alexander says that this is not the case and those who are assisting the shooters will pay dearly.
There is something more into them when they get the opportunity for them to be wanting to wipe out both communities. And I am sending a message to those persons who are involved and their families, because sometimes the families, the girlfriends, the boyfriends, they know who they are because they are the ones who are concealing the weapons for them. And they are using other people to do intelligence for them. And I'm sending a strong message to these people that look, that when somebody gets hurt in this thing, and I'm speaking about when law enforcement end up hurting somebody in this thing, I hope nobody comes to complain.
The acting police commissioner says that the police will be using their intelligence to identify the shooters. The police say it is possible that thugs come from other neighboring communities to ignite war between gangs.
At the end of the day, we are going to get to the root of this thing. And I'm hoping that if and when we use necessary force to combat the force that is presently being used, if anybody gets hurt, I hope that St. Lucians and them have an understanding what is going on. If we are fired at, like some time ago, our people were doing the patrols at Foligua and we are fired at and we use necessary force to retaliate to the force, you know, I hope St. Lucians and them understand that we have a right to protect ourselves. And I'm not, as the acting commissioner of police, I'm not going to allow criminals to kill my police officers without my police officers retaliating.
Alexander says that over the long holiday weekend, police stepped up patrols around the city and withdrew some of the plainclothes police officers in favor of the more visible special service units on the streets. No one has been arrested or charged with any of the murders which took place over the past few days. For the DBS News World, I am Cecil Actil.